I want to say thanks to everyone for coming today. So this is a film, Super Design, which we commissioned the Gallery R & Company to make with Maria Cristina Diderot, who's here with us today, and the filmmaker Francesca Molteni. Muse is her filmmaking company. And we wanted to, the point of this film, which we'll get into a Q&A after, with Franco Odrito, who's one of the original protagonists of the movement, is here with us today. We wanted to capture the history of this Italian radical design movement, which is something that people don't know much about. It's a very important part of the design history that we felt needed to be told. And so many of these designers who are still active today have these incredible stories and in a lot of ways change the way we look at design today. In a way, they're the original kind of radicals who turned the design world on its head and made us look at design as beyond the functional object and to accept it into another realm. So without further ado, I'm just going to get right into the film, and then I look forward to some questions and a very exciting conversation afterwards. Thank you.
Se continui così, perdi il treno. Cucù. Facci il via! Vai, Marco.
Ma ci sono questo tuo figlio?
Ma cosa ne farà di me?
Buongiorno.
Vabbè, se volete io ci sono.
No, può arrivare. Ferruccio
da Roma. Guarda sempre lei.
Grazie.
Sì, sono pronto, uno Ugo, uno del 3, uno del 3, siamo pronti.
Ma lui è
questo Olivetti non è male, scricchiola tutto.
Posso fare dei movimenti di torso, torsionale, non troppo.
Amo la fiction. We need music, make fiction.
Nel pomeriggio del 3 novembre 1976 e nelle prime ore del giorno successivo, una vasta perturbazione atmosferica ha investito la penisola italiana, colpendo con la massima intensità dapprima la Toscana, propagandosi poi in altre regioni italiane. Forti venti, accompagnati da abbondanti precipitazioni, flagellavano nel contempo tutto il litorale, provocando danni notevoli, specie nei piccoli porti della costa tirrenica.
radical movement even exist?
The radical movement is a very complex movement, full of a great energy, because it involved almost 50 people only in Florence.
When I was at the university, there were political groups, and I was involved with some friends in studying what was going on in society, and especially the role of the architect.
The radical virus is still alive, from my point of view. Just spoke about a generation looking for an identity, for his cultural role.
Perché l'importanza di quei movimenti è stata molto nel porsi delle domande. Questi oggetti io dico che sono senza tempo, perché sono più portatori di tutto questo che di una risposta. È così.
Ecco, il momento radicale è stato un momento di interesse sociale molto importante, anche politico. Un momento chiaramente concettuale. Cioè, sono in una società, parlo della mia società, magari con ver politica, ma anche con ironia.
After the 68, nobody likes to be only a small part of a big social mechanism. Everybody wants to have in his hand the future. I am an avant-gardist artist.
Platone e Wimbledon. Come definizione, quella di movimento mi sembra abbastanza giusta. Un gruppo di persone che si conosce, che sta lavorando in una stessa direzione, e questo bello che riconosce che pure nella diversità di quelli che sono i prodotti si accomunava una specie, direi, modo di pensare. Insomma, non è così importante come dire qualcosa se non sei in movimento, ma lo stesso.
Radicale vuol dire lavorare non nel sistema, ma contro il sistema. Il design radicale non è mai esistito, proprio non è mai esistito, non c'era il design radicale. È una invenzione postuma. C'erano gli architetti radicali?
No, non ho nessuna definizione. A salvo che ha preso gran parte della mia vita, ho conosciuto persone con le quali siamo diventati amici, poi quella è la cosa che conta di più.
Non direi movimento, perché in realtà sono stati gruppi molto diversi. All'interno di Archizoom eravamo sei persone completamente diverse.
Abbiamo deciso di ribellarci, non è mica stato difficile. Abbiamo deciso di ribellarci, siamo ribellati, abbiamo cambiato tutto. Quindi, di fatto, abbiamo fatto tante cose importanti. Portato le lotte nei quartieri, e poi naturalmente ci sostenevano tutte le lotte sui diritti civili, quindi l'aborto, il divorzio e così via. È stata una bella stagione, una bella primavera.
Questo qui è stato il primo oggetto fatto con l'alchimia, e quindi il radicale è stato l'incontro con tutta una serie di realtà culturali, con personaggi, con progetti, con visioni, con parole.
Perché la devo mettere qua?
Grande apertura verso il diverso, verso la diversità, verso
lei sta qua.
L'internazionalità. Io ho cominciato a conoscere appunto gli austriaci, gli inglesi, gli americani, Cedric Price.
When they're asking me to talk about Super Studio, I say, well, it's very funny to ask this question again, because everything is in books, exhibition, etc. So it's much better to go back to the documents than asking to the survivor to tell the story. Because every time when you tell a story, you tell a different one. And you are lying, usually. When we were producing our work, Architettura Radicale did not exist. Now Architettura Radicale exists in exhibition and books, and Super Studio doesn't exist anymore.
Nei tempi del controdesign dell'architettura radicale, l'obiettivo di questi personaggi, compreso me, era lo scardinamento e l'uccisione della borghesia. Negli anni io mi sono ritrovato ad essere un borghese. Spero un borghese positivo.
Siccome non sono stati scritti libri, salvo questo sulla generazione esagerata, dentro il movimento c'erano tematiche tra loro molto diverse, anche proprio alternative e conflittuali.
È stato un momento di grande ribellione, di grande fermento, che ha permesso la libertà del design, ma anche ha fatto passare un decoro inutile. Questo dobbiamo dire.
Because the radical design was only protesting, I was never completely agreeing with them. Radical is a position of someone that is not accepting the established order. But if you want to demolish an order, as I said before, you have to create another one. Not a disorder, but another order, which is different.
Like the generation of the hope, and we considered ourselves sons of the Cold War, you know. We were in that situation, so we were free to react against also the division of the world into parts, USA and URSS, and we anticipated in a way the end of ideologies. We were fighting, of course, against modernism, against to consider the modernism a sort of dogma.
E incomincia suonando questo metallo, no? Con le braccia. We were part of that revolution, if you want, of a youth that was claiming the right of conquering a stage. To speak about your own vision.
The political movement in Italy in the 60s and the half part of the 70s was very strong, and the revolution, the social revolution, was a realistic goal for us. When the people are fighting, becomes also creative.
La situazione di noi, direi, protagonisti di questa cosa tra Torino e Firenze, chiaro, era diversa. Torino avevamo la Fiat, che Firenze non ce l'ha, e Torino c'era l'immigrazione fortissima, e allora c'era questo problema anche delle case dove li mettevano a abitare, che vita facevano questi immigrati, eccetera. Pertanto diremmo, forse noi avevamo una presa politica più incisiva, più forte, forse più seriosa, anche più coinvolgente. E Firenze però, dal punto di vista teorico, anche loro erano molto, tra virgolette, di sinistra, perciò era la stessa ricerca.
Abitare e essere ovunque a casa propria.
Cosiddette radicali, diciamo, della fine degli anni 60, si dividono in tre gruppi fondamentali. e quelli che fanno l'autocastrazione, cioè dicono io non voglio lavorare per questa società, non credo a questa società, quindi interrompo il mio lavoro e faccio solo politica. Quelli che dicono no, io non lavoro per questa società e quindi mi dedico ad un'altra società, quindi sono in una dimensione più utopica, quindi pensano a una società diversa. La terza strada, che è la mia strada, è quella di dire sì, io lavoro in questa società, ma per dimostrare e far vedere gli errori di questa società.
Nella periferia della città, proprio dove il sistema è meno efficiente, è più facile rilevare le tracce di un comportamento che è aspirazione alla riappropriazione dell'ambiente, attraverso l'espressione di un desiderio represso di attività creativa che si manifesta concretamente in una certa modificazione del territorio.
You know, after World War II, this was the first piece of resistance towards Italy itself. I mean, it was the first, like, it was the first time that it was sort of like, we're not going to stand in line, we're not going to be westernized in a certain way.
For me, then and now, what happened in the late 60s was a cataclysmic change. What was fascinating about Italian radical design is we now are talking about the world we live in. We're talking about the social change, we're talking about politics, we're talking about anti-bourgeoisie. I mean, we're talking about the real issues of our society.
Insomma, questo è fra i punti più belli di Firenze, perché c'è ancora le stradine.
Un caso strano, è una Firenze così reazionaria, così buia, e dopo tanta repressione è venuto fuori una ribellione, un desiderio di rovesciare il vecchio. E quindi questa ribellione, poi ognuno l'ha vissuta a modo suo.
In questo nostro dedicarci alla politica attiva all'interno della facoltà, ci siamo rivolti ai quartieri, mi occupavamo i municipi dei comuni della cintura per richiedere asili nido, case popolari, consultori per le donne, tutte quelle cose che non c'erano in quegli anni. Quindi abbiamo iniziato un'architettura, diciamo, come arte demolitoria, come denuncia di valori. E abbiamo iniziato quindi in facoltà questo atteggiamento critico. In realtà, insomma, io sono arrivato in una facoltà che era ingessata. Dopo 3 anni che sono in questa facoltà e mi rendo conto che le cose non cambiano. Cioè, qui ci stanno prendendo in giro, qui non stiamo imparando niente. E l'ho detto, ricordo, diventando tutto rosso in faccia, perché ero timidissimo, ho detto secondo me è tempo di dire basta, fermiamo tutto, è finito il tempo dei figli dei fiori, no? Che accettavano di scappare loro dalle città e andare a trovare la pace in campagna, se noi in città ci rimaniamo e al suono del rock la vogliamo riconquistare. Troppo piango io.
Oh, diventa proprio bambino, perché insomma,
no, perché tu non sai, ma lì vicino c'hai le scarpe con le freccette, eh? I torinesi hanno sempre dato l'impressione di essere collegati ai movimenti operaisti, essere organici proprio alla critica marxista dell'economia capitalistica e del sociale, mentre i fiorentini erano più visionari e più artisti. Biennale di Venezia 1980.
He was active in the workers' movement, very, very strong in Italy. And for 10 years I was working, looks like political militants, but also for the new culture. The Fiat, in the past time, it was a network of carrozzieri. I don't know the but at the same time, I was working especially with the younger people, with the group which make music, come murales or political theater and so.
I was a painter, and at a certain point I did realize that painting was not socially relevant, so I decided to become an architect. I was making some sort of connection between the two, these crises. The crisis for modern architecture, which is radical architecture, and the crisis of Florence with the flood.
Il rapporto con Firenze è stato fertile nel senso che, essendo una città che, a cui la modernità era sostanzialmente estranea, proprio l'assenza probabilmente di una società moderna già evoluta favorì l'idea di una modernità diversa. I Beatles sono nati a Liverpool e non a Londra.
We were introduced to the myths of the modern movement. You know? Three houses in which, one of which we will be. That industry and architecture with industry would solve the problem of the universe. The first things that we have done, trying to place into the domestic desert, we call them, our objects in order to provoke reactions, you know, and new behaviors. So we were, in some way, still sons and daughters of the modern movement, ideals and utopia. The invitation, see, because it's taken from the page of the magazine. I hope you have the relics, but I have the original.
Chi è stata as a designer? I thought that art was incapable to make me be witness of reality. So at that time there was in the reality something horrible called Vietnam War, and with my expression I was not able to make any commentary on that.
Anti-war demonstrators protest U.S. involvement in the Vietnam War in mass marches, rallies, and demonstrations. Central Park is the starting point for the parade to the UN building. The estimated 125,000 Manhattan marchers include students, housewives, beatnik poets, doctors, businessmen, teachers, priests, and nuns.
Negli anni 60 il gruppo aveva un senso perché si urlava. Quindi urlando qualcuno faceva attenzione o riceveva attenzione.
E la metodologia era quella del gruppo, del collettivo, cioè lavoravamo e litigavamo dalla mattina alla sera insieme, questo gruppo. Eravamo molto litigiosi.
Forse il gruppo, a mio avviso, più geniale è rimasto a Firenze, intrappolato lì, che sono stati gli UFO di Lapo, Binazzi.
Nel 68 avevo 25 anni. Cioè, 25 anni è il massimo.
Hai guardato il menù?
No. I started like an artist and an experimental architect belonging to the radical movement with the UFO in the 67. During the 60s and the 70s, what inspired the radical movement and also especially UFO was, one, the presentation of pop art, American pop art, in the Biennale in Venice on the 64.
The second was the arising of conceptual art, land art, happening for the UFO was fundamental. This multidisciplinary approach was fantastic, and we understood immediately that we could extend to architecture. We were a group that started by two names, is my name and Sandro Joly. This is one of the pictures of the photos of Global Tools. This is Natalini, this is Branzi, this is Caldini, this is Morozzi, Massimo, Dalisi, Carlo Bachi, Fabrizio Fiumi, Pettena, Mendini, this is La Pietra, this is Raggi, Buti, this is De Ganello. We made the first idea of experimentation with inflated objects. Was chosen in a very sympathetic brainstorming. At the end, in the night, we asked to the telephone service, which is the name of the unidentified flying objects. It was, in a way, the insurance of a long life, because we decided we will stop to be UFO only when the real UFO arrive on the Earth. We worked on the concept of discontinuity, since on that time is a sort of interruption of time. Questa è la Paramount, il disegno è del 69. Questa è proprio una delle dimostrazioni del concetto di discontinuità, no? C'è una discontinuità fra il corpo della lampada e l'ombrello che la ripara. Partiva dal simbolo della Paramount. Era un modo di distribuire i sogni delle case cinematografiche attraverso i simboli e anche una specie di rottamazione, no? Ecco, for control uscio. Questa è del 69, è del ristorante Sherwood. E questa è una mezzaluna che io avevo disegnato per un ristorante a New York, come un tableau, un quadro scultura, e poi ho deciso di farci una lampada. Vuoi che te lo dica in inglese?
Sì.
They are not static objects, but they are objects for performing. The more that you can imagine, you can kill people with a knife, you can use just to heating your hands during the winter, and so on. Si vede qualcosa? Ah. So we created a grammar of representation that was a sort of permanent brainstorming, something similar to the nuclear explosion.
We were in our middle 20s, an explosion of, come si dice, hormones, no? Allora, vai, apriamo, 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 tutti i quattro e infiliamo contemporaneamente le braccia. Uno, due e tre. Oh! Chiudi. Il mio primo lavoro è questo loft che io mi sono autocostruito quando ero studente d'architettura. Architecture, having digested the lesson of rationalism, becomes a novel, becomes a way to speak about your conditions, your necessities of negotiating in between your rationalist and your emotional side. Questo, vedi, è una costruzione alta 2,5 metri. Poi c'è un attore con una tuta con tante medagliette metalliche attaccate. Per cui il danzatore deve cominciare, questo è di metallo, sono tanti anelli quadrati di metallo, e incomincia suonando questo metallo, no? Con le braccia. E questo è uno strumento musicale. Questo è disegnato nel 62-63. Architecture is a sort of a derelict field where you never see the things you imagine. You have always to deal with ideas of architecture you can reproduce only in a reduced scale. So you never see your language at work. The wearable chairs are the instruments to measure, also in a metaphoric manner, the spaces that are somehow proportioned to the scale of man. L'isola d'Elba c'ha, oltre a essere una mia architettura fatta a mano, quindi un po' a valle della mia esperienza nelle comunità hippie in America, c'è tutta una presenza di Andrea Branzi, che ha una banderuola. Ed ecco, a sinistra questo è Ettore e quello lì è Mendini. Vedi com'è fatta quella scala lì, tun, 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 si sale in una stanzina. Quindi appena ti alzi c'è questo pianerottolo triangolare in cui sono disegnate delle nuvole, vedi? Questo è un mosaico però, dove ogni tessera è rotta a mano. Vedi, ti alzi, c'hai ancora la testa nelle nuvole, vedi? Poi cominci a compitare più o meno per diviso uguale mondo reale. La casa non è una casa, è stato definito Petenas Village. My friends were Yanis Kounellis, Mario Merz, Eliseo Mattiacci, Alighiero Boetti, Robert Smithson, Gordon Matta Clark when I was in the States, etc. But not the other so-called radicals. Ci siamo tutti? Chi manca? Un luogo così è abbastanza insolito, eh? Our love for architecture was endorsing ourselves to make architecture with the instruments of art, not the instruments of a professional architect.
Cheers!
Cheers! Cheer. Io potrei fare il Joker, per esempio.
Perché effettivamente adesso un architetto vorrebbe fare un museo, vorrebbe fare... Allora, proprio quello che voleva di più fare, che desiderava avere, finalmente fare una discoteca. gambe sono diverse, le abbiamo fatte dopo, perché sai che erano su dei cubi. Io che ne ho fatte tre, l'ero visto come una persona troppo fortunata, perché poi le hanno fatte tutti, tutti hanno cercato di fare il ricotetto. Tutta la società a quel tempo era in agitazione, era bello, interessante, ma è tutto finito con le Brigate Rosse. No, del materiale chiedevano, poi ne hanno chiesto un altro. E il Piper di Torino è nato un po' in relazione col Piper, in relazione, c'era il Piper di Roma, della gente di Torino ha detto facciamo il Piper a Torino. E questo era una cosa importante, perché era creare uno spazio in cui si sperimentava nuovi modi di relazioni. E questo faceva un po' parte, no, del fatto che è un'architettura che è legata un po' alle trasformazioni sociali, che vuol dire anche trasformazioni di comportamenti. Qui è Sperone, questa sono io, questo è Boetti,
esatto,
questo è Pistoletto,
sì,
questo è Gilardi, per cui c'è stata una reazione molto forte, talmente forte questi signori che l'avevano proposta, l'avevano anche messo i soldi per farla, sono spaventati, hanno detto lo chiudo, come chiude questa meraviglia di spazio che ho progettato, non è possibile chiuderlo, e allora ho detto lo gestisco io. Questo il Piper è diventato un luogo dove ha fatto l'esposizione tutta l'arte povera, dove è venuto il Living Theater. Tutte queste discoteche avevano anche questo elemento della flessibilità. Cosa vuol dire? Che non è che si costruisce lo spazio, la forma, ma si dà occasione al pubblico di dare la forma. C'era anche il design, c'era l'allestimento di questo spazio discoteca. Le cose che comunicavamo meglio erano un po' di oggetti di design, per esempio la gufa nasce più o meno in quegli anni lì. La cosa forse molto importante è stata, possiamo dire, chiamare l'architettura degli interni. Sono dei momenti in cui delle innovazioni diventano molto importanti, anche se sono un po' stupide, per il fatto di aver scoperto che c'era il poliuretano. Non è che sia una cosa così, no, non c'era bisogno di Socrate, solo dall'America, dall'America è arrivato questo materiale. Non era una specie di festival del poliuretano, che era stimolato una cosa tutta dura, rigida, come fosse un pezzo di marmo. Dopodiché invece ti sedevi, ti sorprendeva perché ti affondavi, però quando ti alzavi poi tornerà marmo. Era anche direi una speranza di un rinnovamento globale, si poteva fare tutto. La prima cosa che ti viene in mente è di rifare la natura. Cosa rifaccio? Cos'è la cosa più importante della natura? Ecco, che è anche complessa perché è organica, è difficile da riprodurre. La natura la possiamo riprodurre, ma la possiamo anche reinventare. Da quello è nato il Pratone. Sono ossessionato dal Pratone. Per favore, il Pratone no.
The Gufran in 1966 was just a little atelier with, you know, young students from the Polytechnic of Torino. They just invited to play and do things. Piero Gilardi obviously was the mastermind behind the invention of the Gufran and behind what we were doing there. So these guys, they were there, they were playing, they were creating things, and they didn't know that they were making history.
Vai Giacomo, vai Giacomo!
Ma normalmente sono sulle 90 ore a fare un pratone, da zero a costruirlo, a tagliarlo, a modellarlo, a stuccarlo. Ma allora io sono andato a 13-14 anni a lavorare e ho visto della spugna, dei particolari che sembrava una cosa, ad esempio il cartus era una cosa fuori dal mondo, una cosa sembrava venuta dalla luna, dallo spazio.
Goofram was two brothers at that time working out of a garage. Was very impressed by their response and decided this is a company that we really have to take care of. And we started buying all their fantasy pieces, and of course, they became very popular.
My research with the new material was related with the radical movement of the design. In the 60s, no, we feel that the industrial social model was bad and dangerous, but at the same time, the artists, the intellectual people keep a sort of fiducia, confidence, a sort of confidence in the techno science, yeah. I was friends with many radical architects. I was working with the Goofram, which is a factory that produces a special object of design in polyurethane form.
So. This is a crepe line, you can see, no? And everything is moving. The trees are dancing, you have lights, you have music, no? Also interactive music, because the people, no? Can interact here, no? With a sense of. Installation, no, in the 89, so it's very old. I exposed this installation in New York to the Speroni Water Gallery in the 91, and I remember that especially the young people was dancing with the trees.
Some ecologists may say polemics with me because I use the polyurethane form, which becomes from the oil.
This filo rosso è stato un grande riflusso fino agli anni 70, eccetera. Allora, un primo maggio, poi ho pensato di dire, dobbiamo ritrovare il filo rosso, no? Della lotta, dell'unità.
Chi da una parte lamenta atti di violenza, i giovani protestano, vi sono scontri con la polizia. Il 5 dicembre, un sciopero di solidarietà con i ragazzi del Mamiani in molte scuole romane.
Essendo tutte queste discipline, architettura, art e design, in un momento storico tra di loro molto collegate, l'arte si poteva fare non più soltanto con il quadro, ma anche con il corpo, con la foto, con la performance, eccetera, ma anche l'architettura non era più il costruito e quindi si poteva fare architettura anche con una performance, con un film, con una foto e anche al limite con il corpo. Io cercavo proprio di portare questi passaggi sinestetici, perché sinestesia vuol dire travaso proprio tra una disciplina e l'altra, quindi la mia attività rispetto forse a quella di altri radicali è stata quella proprio di attraversare le varie discipline. Il mio lavoro è influenzato soprattutto dai movimenti degli anni 50 dell'Internazionale Situazionista e quindi, come fortemente politicizzato, come quasi tutti i movimenti che si sono espressi negli anni 60, soprattutto a Milano, anche con una volontà di intervento capace di essere, la parola che uso spesso, decodificatorio.
Sulla base dell'incarico ricevuto dalla direzione della Triennale per la progettazione generale di questa importante mostra internazionale.
Da 74 in poi io riesco a fare qualcosa di rivoluzionario, chiamiamolo così. Trovare degli oggetti, tra virgolette, radicali, laddove infatti non sono dei mobili, eccetera, eccetera. Quindi sono delle strane cose che però sono alla scala dell'oggetto.
Hanno la serie di finestre che
e per la prima volta si vedono degli oggetti fatti dai radicali.
Tieni conto che i cosiddetti design radicali veri erano designer che rifiutavano delle commesse di fare progettare oggetti. Noi eravamo contro il consumismo.
The general public was just laughing at our works. And the architects thought that we were very stupid young guys and so on. So when I started being a serious architect, nobody did trust me. They said, well, it's another joke of Super Studio now. Natalini is trying to present himself as a real arch, but we know it's a joke. But it was a nice period, and I am quite happy in remembering that, even if for different reason, this is not the most important part of my life. Superstudio was a necessary movement in that period because it was the counterpart of the international architecture, the beginning of globalization and so on. So we use negative utopia as a tool for fighting against this sort of reality which we did not like very much. So the Superstudio started officially the story in 66 and went on for 20 years. But the so-called radical period, or the theoretical work of Superstudio, has been produced between 66 and 72. 72 was the exhibition, Italy Domestic Landscape. On the beginning, we were producing the stable by ourselves. And so at the end, Zanotta bought the whole thing, and he's still producing. That one in Pistoia was the first one, but in fact, it was showing things which have been done afterward. This was an exhibition of, let's say, architecture students which have nearly graduated, so all these things are our diploma work.
And in 1966, Adolfo, as a painter, was invited by a gallery in Pistoia to make an exhibition of his paintings, of his work. And at that time, he said that he would have asked other friends to participate, and came out Super Architettura. Came out something that was not art, architecture, sculpture, but was all of this. This exhibition was the beginning of the whole matter, but it was a beginning that saw two groups born, Archezoom and Superstudio.
La solitudine a momenti disperati della gente colta alla sprovvista di sorpresa e i fiumi d'acqua e di fango che vanno sempre più forte.
The show had to be postponed because of the flood, of course. I was on a hill. Adolfo was down in the town and his office was, his studio was completely destroyed, as other studios were destroyed. And this is the reason why I called him and I said, why don't you come up in the hill of Bellosguardo where I was living. At that time, we started understanding that architecture was not only a matter of materials, but it was a ritual. It was so much into the mind as much as was into the making of things. I'm sorry, this robe here is plastic laminated with Ahmed print, for which I photographed a piece of grass from up above. And then with the silkscreen was made into the laminated sheet. So we were trying to break the discipline by doing photomontage, cardboard, very colored models, music, and words like in a theater.
And here is he.
This implied a new way of communicating architecture. It was the way of fighting against the system inside the system.
It's the portable with the two handles. Histogramma da passeggio.
If you come out with a strange name, Super Studio, which is similar to Super Soap, to Super Gasoline, to a brand name, you are more ambiguous about where to push, in which place to set this formation of people, this group of action.
Italian domestic landscape.
This is the invitation.
Yes.
Poltronova is a very important part in the history of Italian design. I think that the two most influential people in that period were Camilli Poltronova and Gavina.
La collaborazione tra i gruppi radicali, Superstudio, Archizum e Poltronova è nata perché Poltronova li ha trovati, cioè Camilli li ha trovati. Camilli non certo non si poteva definire l'imprenditore come siamo abituati a immaginarsi, l'imprenditore serio con l'azienda, le serie aziende del nord, come diceva Ettore.
Ettore has been only Ettore Sozzos.
Ettore però non è mai stato radical. Sì. Diciamo che la figura di Ettore fu importante perché si stabilì con lui un legame di amicizia molto, molto forte.
Ettore was indicating to us that you could practice your architectural language in one-to-one scale. It was an inspiration. He, through his work, he was telling us with architecture, you can make love, even love.
Non è un caso che il radical design abbia offerto all'universo industriale, diciamo, al mondo della fabbrica, dell'azienda, delle possibilità evolutive verso territori che normalmente non erano considerati praticabili.
Per inventarti le parole, quindi per parlare delle cose contemporanee, tu hai bisogno anche di materiali che siano capaci di parlare di quelle cose. Ad esempio, quegli anni lì erano nate le materie plastiche. Tra l'altro, le materie plastiche si prestavano benissimo al nostro pensiero, perché erano di nuovo, erano di nuovo materiali finti. Noi volevamo delle cose finte, ori finti, marmi sintetici, nuvole di stagnola. Erano tutte cose che erano le cose kitsch. Tu pensi, il divano bocca era scolpito a mano, quindi con la Gufra ne abbiamo scolpiti 10 di divani a bocca, tutti a mano da mandare in America. E dopo qualche mese ce lo ritroviamo su Life, due pagine centrali con la Marisa Berenson che fa la diva sul divano a bocca.
Ed è anche una comoda poltrona.
Noi disegnavamo il Contorella di Milano, che erano un architettore di interni, e gli oggetti li disegnavamo per i nostri interni, non era design. Poi il fatto che siano stati prodotti è stato un caso.
Un passaggio importante è stata la mostra Italy New Domestic Landscape, organizzata da Emilio Ambaz al MoMA di New York, dove per la prima volta il movimento radicale era visto, come io personalmente l'ho sempre visto, come una parte significativa del design italiano complessivo.
Un giorno in uno studio suona il campanellino e entra questo signor Ambaz e mi dice: vuoi fare una mostra a New York?
At MoMA we had several stages. There were the traditional designers, or what I used to call nastily, the conformists, and then we had the contestatory, and then we had of course the radicals.
Allora abbiamo pensato di prendere questo riferimento di questo fumetto, farlo diventare una cosa seria, raccontare quello che succedeva in Italia. Da lì sono nati i fotoromanzi.
The main point of Italian design in 1972, when I did the show, was to show the immense amount of commitment that Italian designers had to criticize society using design, which to the Americans, that they couldn't understand it. People tell me it's quite memorable because Italians are very conscious politically of the context. Americans are completely naive about the context. Well, it really had a great impact on American designers. Many of them were, of course, offended immensely, deeply by the fact that here was those Italians making curves and making color, using colors and things of that sort, which they, Americans, were brought up in the great Bauhaus tradition of repression.
But if Bauhaus were indicated like belonging to the first avant-garde, we were recognized like the Bauhaus after the war.
Global Tours è stato un momento di grandissima tensione emotiva, teorica, per produrre un'utopia che poi non si è realizzata.
Non eravamo preparati, cioè questa cosa del mestiere, perché a parole è una cosa, ma il mestiere è una cosa seria.
Milano fu l'occasione per dividerci ognuno per i sentieri che ci sembravano più consoni alle propri lavori.
Ci siamo divertiti molto, ma lo dico adesso.
Sì, il delirio di poter progettare tutto.
La maggior parte delle cose sono state salvate è dalle maestranze, perché alla fine loro avevano, secondo me, in fondo veramente capito di che si stava parlando.
These pieces really just basically turned it upside down and were so expressive and so powerful and again challenged your idea of beauty, of what something could be.
I think radical design was really the only period that I felt that was corresponding with what I was collecting in art, in the sense that it's radical, it's opening new roads and breaking with the past, but kind of respecting history in a way. I found this kind of combination of, let's say, respecting the history and knowing about it, but at the same time opening new roads. And that was a very exciting moment for me.
Subito dopo, anni 70, c'è il rigetto del mercato che dice queste cose sono invendibili, sono improponibili, non si possono collocare, rovina le case.
Io prendo le distanze da quelli che sono il movimento radicale. Posso dire che io sono stato, per un certo momento, sono stato vicino a queste esperienze. Ma...
Radical design, if I now try to remember, it was radical in the form, but it never measured itself with the very important goal.
For the new generation, it's very important to see and to understand what we do in the 60s. Why? Because the young people, a lot of young people are so passive, no? Are narcotizzati. By the media.
In realtà è una critica all'ideologia, nascosta nei linguaggi dell'architettura, del design e delle cose. Perché tu racconti?
Architecture, my idea was a sort of landscape, a sort of stage, which is very simple. And on that stage you can play your life with this comedy and dramas and maybe you can be able to look for some sort of happiness, and that's all.
Today, I think that it's time to reread Marx.
Freedom is to continue to open doors and not to shut. Not shut doors, but open doors.
La ribellione è possibile. The rebellion is possible.
Sempre vissuto con la successione di stili, dagli egiziani fino ad oggi. Cioè noi avevamo sempre delle piccole gabbie che ci costruivamo dove il barocco, il neoclassico, eccetera, eccetera.
Felice di essere qui con Giacomo oggi, perché Giacomo, dopo 43 anni di lavoro alla Gufra, la prossima settimana se ne va finalmente in pensione.
Franco,
super design!
L'acqua molto fine!
Super design!
The lion, Franco.
Yeah. Oh, is there a slideshow?
Sorry? Good morning, everybody, and thanks for being here with us to, at this matinee. And it's pretty much emotional all the time that I go back to this movie, because maybe for you that was a lot of fun and possibly and hopefully very interesting, but every time then I realized that those guys really drove us crazy. That has been like a journey four year and a half journey. And what I really would like to say is that we wanted report what is actually the feeling and emotions and of course the dreams that are still there today. So there's nothing nostalgic about it, and doesn't want to give like a comprehensive overview about this very fragmented and difficult period to portray movement. We can call it as you see, none of those guys has the same idea about something. So it has been for us very much interesting, and we try to give to portray with this movie what is actually there today.
So the film is very much about the history, but we wanted to make a film that was also about the future, I think, in many ways, because so much of what you hear in these stories is not one point of view, but again, an emotional journey that took place, and that design had a purpose. There was more to it than the fashion or the style or the new materials or the form. There was ideas behind it, and this is something that design, I think, can do very powerfully with the people that interact with it. And that's things that we forget sometimes, that design can actually serve a purpose beyond the functionality. And I think that's the idea that was taking place at this time, that I think we could incorporate a lot more in a way into design again and say something beyond the typical conversations we have about how much something costs or how comfortable it is. Design actually, you interact with these objects in a different way, and they can be very emotional. So I think that's one of the most important things. And like Maria Cristina said, to capture these stories. And there's not one answer, you see. No one has the same opinion in the end. And we can do so much more. So this is hopefully going to encourage not just us, but the young designers of the future to maybe reevaluate what they can do with their work.
Ready?
thank you to for coming and to share with us this experience, the memory of this experience. But the thing I like very much about this movie done by Maria Cristina Didero is the fact that they are talking, the movie is talking about one experience that is old, 50 years almost, from the 65 to 75. But they are not talking about this experience to celebrate an experience, to say, oh, how good we were, because in any case, we were not good at all. But it's something just to try to communicate an experience that for sure had a big importance at the time on the revolution of the languages, of the design, of the architecture. But mainly it's an experience that still now we have to consider it's alive. It's an example of an attitude where the young people who don't like or they want to change the world, they believe they can change the world, they act on the direction to modify the world on which they are living. It is an attitude that I think it's a message that is extremely actual today in the world where we are living. So the fact that to relate the activity, to criticize whatever is around you that you don't like, and to fight to change this world, that is the common element, all the people that you saw. Each one coming from different experience, each one living this fact in a different way, but all in common, they want to fight to change that world, that it was horrible, it was gray, it was didn't allow the freedom. No. So I think today, more than at that time, this message should be passed to the young generation. the young generation that should know that they still have in their hands the design of the future. They can design the future. They have to fight to make a different future. They cannot accept the world in the way it is. No? And the fact that the people are becomes conscious on the fact that they can act to change the world, of course, is bring the people to express themselves with new objects, with new languages, because to design a future, design a new world, you need to use a new language. To design your future, you cannot use the element of the past. You have to invent something. You have again to discover the imagination as a strong power on which you can modify. And nothing like imagination, nothing like the ironical approach can destroy the things that is unacceptable on the world where we are living. So I think this is a message that we can read from this movie. It is a message that the radical movement has to promote in the actual world. No? But I don't want to be long.
Go ahead.
I can go ahead.
Do we have any questions?
Yeah, I prefer if somebody has a question, to give a space to you, because let's say one of the most important points of all these groups, it was the open mind, the fact that we were groups, we were not individual archistars, no one. Let's say everybody was Archizoom, Super Studio, Studio 65, group of people who were living already according with a new model of life. We were together, we were in communities, we were discussing about what we want to do on the world, what should be the future. The things we were designing were the things that are already part of the new world, are already part of the future we were designing. No? Means, so, let's say the attitude is not, let's say, an art politically engaged, no. Let's say we were politically engaged, each one fighting. I was from Torino, means I have been living the big 68 in Torino with the factories and the student movement. The people in Florence, they have been living different kind of experience. No? But the things we were producing, at the moment you are conscious of the things that you don't accept on the world that is around you, no? And you fight, politically you fight to change the world, it's normal that your imagination, you become free. You are exercise your freedom, and at the moment you exercise your freedom, the things you are designing are new. No? It's a product of your new status. It's not the fact to make something politically engaged. No, Lipsoff is not politically engaged, but it's a strong ironical object that is criticized the new, civilization based on the appearance. No? It was the time of the image. Now, the appearance was much more important than the reality. It's important how you appear and not important what you are thinking. So you can have a nice car, you can show the people something, but it doesn't matter what you are thinking. No? Nobody's asking. What are you thinking? No, this lady is a beautiful lady. The image becomes more important than the thought. No? So Lipsofa is representing that kind of, is an ironical approach against a society that was privileging the appearance. But that doesn't mean is an engaged object. It's a nice object, sensual object. With change the language of, of the design. From that moment, a sofa is not a place where two arms, a back, and cushions, and this and that. Sofa can be anything. Can be the sofa of my friend Porky. No? Let's say... Okay, okay, thank you, thank you. No, because she's my moderator. So,
Emilio Ambash in the film suggests that America is unsophisticated and the Italians were showing another way to approach things. But you could say that some of the movements from Florence took a lot from America. The happenings, the be-ins, the love-ins were really American innovations. What do you think?
No, no. Let's say on the 60s, we used to love America. Let's say for us, there was the time of the Beat Generation. It was the time of the rock and roll. It was a revolution, no? Really, it was the time of the pop art. Pop art had a very important influence on all of the things we were doing. Let's say. We were referring, for sure, we were referring to the avant-garde of the beginning of the century. Let's say we were getting from Italian avant-garde or international avant-garde, but from Europe mainly. So from the futurism, we were getting a lot. Let's say from the Dadaist. From the surrealist, but for sure the pop art experience becomes very important because allow us to express our ideas. Each object was saying a story, no? And the fact that to use the macroscopic to make macroscopic the object to change the scale, that was a way to communicate the message. No, so Lipsofa is enormously lips, and the same let's say the Capitello, the same the other things, and so for sure we got great influence. I think what Emilio Ambaz is saying, it was mainly related not to the artistic movement, but related to the profession of the designers. Yes. I think. Where maybe, I don't know what it was in the state, but he's saying that, where maybe the people were feeling they have to be still modernist. No? While in Europe, we discovered that the modernism, it was dead. Because the modernism, it was a avant-garde on the beginning of the last century, that was born with a very big, a nice ideals. No, at the time that avant-garde, the modernism, want to get married with the industrialization, to distribute through the production all the objects to everybody. Means to diffuse the object not only for to the rich people but to all the population through the machine to the production to reduce the work of the labor and to increase the wealth, no, of everybody, all things that were dreams of the avant-garde, of the modern avant-garde, that was destroyed. It was not fulfilled with, let's say, Bauhaus was closed by Hitler. And then that kind of, let's say, industrial era brought to the Second War. So it means were all promises that were not maintained. And we were realizing that. And now the only remaining part of the modernism, it was the, let's say, the horrible periferie urbane, cioè, let's say, neighborhood on the town. The, so for us, to fight against the modernism means to fight against a society that were absolutely didn't maintain the promises, and to rediscover something else. Eh?
So let's see, because I know everybody doesn't have so much time. We need one microphone. Are there any other questions? I hope that we have any other questions here. No. Okay. Alexandra.
I'd like to know if you think there are any young radical designers today, and if so, who are they?
It's a good question.
Thanks, Alexandra.
And I think, in fact, I think that there are. I think that there's a new thing happening in contemporary design that is definitely becoming influenced by some of what we're talking about here. At least I've seen a new freedom in some of the younger designers, where there's this newer incorporation again of the craft with a very sort of push more towards the combination of contemporary art and design. This is clearly happening. You see it throughout the fair and throughout, you know, a lot of the young designers. There's a new generation where the idea of production has changed, of what design really means. It's not about mechanical innovation. It's so much more about ideas again. And this is, I think, what we hope to see more and more of, that people are trying to make a statement about gender or things of that nature, that's starting to come back into conversation. So I do see it happening. I don't think it's it has a lot more room to grow, but certainly I see it throughout. In America in particular, there's a lot of young artists working in this way. And I think it started, people like Porky and people like that are starting to push these boundaries. And this is exciting, because this is like a new generation. So we're like at the beginning maybe of a new wave of ideas in the design world. What do you think, expert in design?
Thank you. If being radical means be free, create your own language, even if it's a strong one, it's a controversial, whatever it is, while respecting other people, not only people, themes like sustainability and all these things, I do believe that there are, thank God, some radical young guys that can be associated with this word. What do you think, Franco? No, the voice doesn't stop. Sorry.
I think the great achievement of the film is to have these eyewitnesses with their words. That's the historical achievement of the film. If you would believe everyone, what he says or she says, you get lost within that issue, because it's all the personal point of view that these persons have. Some are better with marketing themselves, some are not so good in marketing themselves. Some are critical, some are quite uncritical. And I had the chance to meet one of the protagonists one of those days. And the funny thing is, when, as a journalist, I questioned an issue, he said to me, Klaus, who wants to know the truth as long as people are offered legends?
So I guess without any more questions, we'd just like to say thank you again, and hopefully we can inspire people with this film. And it's been a great opportunity for us to share this, and the film has been traveling all over the world. It's showing in London tomorrow, and it's been in many festivals across the globe. So we hope that this message gets out there to a bigger public. And if you are all interested, there is a book also, a component of this film. We produced an exhibition which started in New York and has traveled to the Toronto Italian Cultural Institute, and hopefully will continue to travel. But there's also a book, which they do have out here in the bookstore. So please, if you're interested, pick up a copy. And yes, so.
The promotional moment.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.